operations on array elements. So if you take an array within the array, what are the operations are performed on the arrays? So in that we will discuss about the one dimensional arrays. So within the one dimensional arrays, what are the operations are done through this one? So in that mainly are in the different types of the operations. The first one is something the reading data into the array. In that you must have the reading data into the array. That means you can read the array elements. How to read the array elements? Next, printing the data. After reading the data, next one is you can print the data. And if you are taking the reading the element or printing the data, all are done through the for loops only. Next, if you are taking the arrays within the arrays, if you are doing any operations, each and every operation must be done using the loopings. In that mind, we are in the for looping. Next one is something the finding the largest element. So within the given array, what is the largest element you are having, that must be used to find the largest element. Next, in that you can also find out the sum of the array and the average elements of the array. And in that you can take the sum and average of elements of the array. Within the given elements, what is the sum of the given array elements and what is the average elements in him? Now I will give you the, so what is the code you want to implement for this one? So you reading, you want to read this one, how to read this elements. After reading the element, you want to print the element. Next, largest element. Largest element means that you can compare the one element with the another element and finally which one is the largest element. And sum and average means in the first of all you must find the sum. You can add the one element after the other element. After that, you can take the average of the these elements. So these are the four operations we will discuss through the one example. So this is the example for this operations. In the containing the operations, fill array means reading the elements on the array. Print array means can print the elements on the array. Sum of array means sum array. And find the largest element in the array. So these are the four operations. So in the first time taken the method common array methods. This is the class. The first time starting with the function fill array. That means reading the elements on the array in list comma n. So the array is stored in the elements in list. So create scanner object for keyboard input. That means in that you want to read the elements through the keyboard. If you want to read any element through the keyboard, at that time you can use the scanner object. So in that I am using the scanner console equals means scanner system.in. So this is the syntax you are read for reading the element from the keyboard. So for int I equals 0, I less than n, I plus plus. So list of I equal console dot next int. So it will be read all the elements until you have completed the L. So n represents the size of the elements. Next one is after reading the elements, next you want to print the elements. If you want to print the elements, in that case I am taking the other method public static void print array in list comma n. So in that you can print the list of elements. So again I am using the for loop for I equal 0, I less than n, I plus plus. System dot 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 print list of I. So that means what are the elements you are having on the list? That list must be printed one after the other until completion of the list. So that is the second method. And the third method is you want to find out the sum of the array. So that means within the array elements, you want to find the total of all the elements of the array. So in that I mean the method public static int sum array. In that int list comma int n. So initially sum value equal to 0. Now I am taking the for loop for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. Sum equal to sum plus list of I. So initially sum value is 0. After that, you can add the sum to the one element of the other element and you can return the sum value. So, this is the method of the sum of the array. Next, I am going to find out the largest element. The largest element means I want to give the what is the index of the largest element. So, in that int max equal 0, for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, If list of max is greater than list of i, initially max value is 0. If list of max, that means list of 0 is greater than list of i. That means in that we compare the one element with the another element. So that means 0 and next element. So in that you can take this one, the max equal to i. So what is the i value? I have that one and that one the max value. So these are the four methods we want to take the operations. Next I am going to the main method. So the main method means public class operation demo. In that public static void main string arguments. Final int size equal to 4. So in that I am taking the final keyword and the size of the array is 4. So int array equal to new int size. So in that I am declaring the creating the array. Declaration and creation of the array. Next system.out.out printer will enter numbers. So in that I want to read the elements. If you want to read array elements, in that case you can call the method fill array. So in that common array methods, the name of the class. So common array methods dot fill array, array comma size. So using that one, it will fill the all the elements. Or it can read the elements. After that, you can print these elements. So system.out.out printer will numbers are. If you want to print the elements, in that case you can call the method print array method. So common array method dot print array array comma size. After that it will print the elements. Next I am giving the one gap. After printing the elements, next I want to find out the sum of the elements. If you want to take sum of the elements, at that time you can call the method sum array method. So in that case you can take the system dot out dot print array. The sum of the elements is common array method dot sum array array comma size. After printing the sum of the array elements, next you want to find out the largest element. So system.out.out printer will largest element at index. So which index it will contain the largest element is common array method dot largest element array comma size. So this is the main method. So this is the example of the find out the operations on the arrays. The next topic is assigning array to another array. So that means in that we are assigning one array to another array. That is similar to the copying arrays. So what is the meaning of the copying of the arrays? We are copying the one array elements to the another array elements. If you want to do this process, in that we are in the three ways are used for copying the elements. In that we are in the three ways or methods are used to copy the array elements. So in that the first one is use a loop to copy individual elements. In that here in the loop to copy the individual elements. That means in that here is the for loop. So within the for loop you can copy the one element of the another individual elements one by one. So what is this meaning? So easy loop for copy individual elements means suppose for I equal to 0, I less than I plus plus, A of I equal to B of I. That means in that if you are taking the for A of I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus, in that b of I equal to a of I. Suppose if we are taking like that. So a is already existed array. You can copy the elements of the array element a into array elements b. So that means in that you can apply the equal operator. In the equal operator you can copy the individual elements one after the other. So this is the first method. And the second method is comes under the in that here in the one method use the static here in the one method that is the array copy. In that here in the method array copy method. So this is the in that you can use the array copy method. This method is in the system class. can mail the what is the process you want to use, how to copy the one element to the another element. And next one is comes under the third method is comes under the use of the clone method. In that you can apply the clone method to copy arrays. So these are the three methods. The first one is equal assign operator. So in that most probably cannot prefer this one. In that you can use the array copy method for copying the elements. And if you take the clone method will be discussed in later chapters. So now we will discuss about the how to use this array copy method for copying the elements. Okay, now I will give you the one example for under the syntax of this array copy. Okay, now we will take the what is the syntax of the array copy method. So array copy, what is the source array, source position, and target array, target position and length. That means in that you are copying the source array to target array. Within the source array, what is the position you want to start? That starting position is nothing but the source position. And within the target array, what is the starting position of the target array? And what is the length of the target array? So that is the syntax of the copy array. Now I am giving you one example. In the public class array copy, public static void main string argument, that is the main function. In that I am taking the source array. The source array contains the element 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So total array having the 6 elements. So now I am creating the another array destination. The so in that I create the array new int of 5. So that destination array must contain the length 5 elements. So now I am applying the array copy system dot array copy. The first file is source file and the position is 1. So actually I have started from 0, but in that I want to copy from 1 to remaining elements. So 1 and destination, in that the starting position is 0 and total number of elements is 5. So system and ordered printed arrays dot two string destination. So what are the values here happening in the destination, that the values must be printed. If you take that one, the output must become under the so the first element means 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is the output of this program. So this is the process of assigning array to another array, one array element to the another elements.